Hi, welcome to my talk, Orchestrating Your Cloud Orchestra. This is by me, Abram Hindle, from the Department of Computing Science, University of Alberta. So, imagine you want an orchestra of synthesizers and data analyzing processes that maybe do computer vision or music information retrieval. You've got this whole network where the computer vision, music information retrieval stuff informs your synthesizers are all connected together. It's a multiple computer network. It's a lot of work. And eventually you mix all that audio and you play it. This is quite valuable because a lot of times you can't get enough CPU power into one computer, so oftentimes you have to use multiple computers. The problem with this scenario is that if you want to go and perform with it, you're going to have to carry all those computers there, and you're going to have to set up that network. So it's going to take a lot of time and a lot of testing, and there's a lot of errors that could occur along the way, like parts getting loose. It'd be really useful if you could leave such a network set up and access it remotely. In fact, it'd be even greater if you didn't even have to own those computers, and that you could just rent them. So, what I propose is basically a cloud orchestra. An orchestra of computer synthesizers in the cloud. And by cloud, I mean basically VMs that you can provision at will. Essentially, the benefit that we get from the cloud is that we can treat computation much like we treat utilities such as electricity. Flick a switch, the lights turn on. Provision some VMs, your computation occurs, and you get to use those machines for computational purposes. So really what we want to do is we want to flick the switch and turn on our cloud orchestra so we can hear our various synthesizers all working together in the cloud. There's benefits of this. We don't have to actually rent the cloud orchestra virtual machines for the entire duration. We can simply have them rented for the duration of the performance. So we actually don't need to rent these computers for very long. One of the problems with using a cloud orchestra is that the cloud is virtual and it's on the internet. It's far away. So you incur the latency time to speak with the cloud, and you also have to incur you also have to encode the audio such that you can hear it. So you incur a lot of latency this way, and you have to communicate over the internet, and the reliability of the internet is not great. So the motivation of this talk and this work is that we want to make music, and we want to make music using the cloud. What we don't want to do is sysadmin a ton of virtual machines or computers. We really just want to make computer music in the cloud using cloud resources. But in order to do this, we actually have to take on a lot of responsibilities. We have to basically take on the responsibilities of a sysadmin. We have to take on the responsibilities of a developer in order to make sure our scripts are automated and our orchestra can start up appropriately. We have to take on DevOps skills to orchestrate this creation and connection of the cloud resources. And then we also still have to make music. We have to compose it and we have to play it. So we have to be a musician as well. This is a lot to ask. This is a lot of hats, especially if you really just wanted to wear the musician hat. The rest of it's quite annoying. So essentially, a computer musician who wants to use a cloud approaches a gulf of execution. This means that there's something in their way. There's a bunch of things that they have to do before they can get what they want, their goal. There's resource allocation, there's configuration and coordination. These are all skills you need to pick up from, say, DevOps. So, what's a solution? Well, model-driven development can be a solution to this. With model-driven development, you think of a model of your problem or a model of your actual solution. You then take that model, you implement it, you describe it to a computer, and you describe that model using the modeling framework's MetaModel. And then that model is fed into a model generator, and that model generator will generate source code and executables that you can use to execute the problem that you have modeled. Furthermore, because these things are generated, you can actually customize some of them, and this allows you to basically make things look the way you want, or to customize them for other platforms that might not be addressed and things like that. So, model-driven development can be used to take, say, a model of a synthesizer network, Cloud Orchestra, and produce a deployment plan from there. The deployment plan would basically be the allocation of our synthesizers to computers in the cloud. Essentially, we want to take a model, we want to give it to a model generator, and it makes a deployment plan. So, what we can do is, to the optimizer or the model generator, we can provide our model, we can provide a description of our resources, the cloud resources available to us, or perhaps in the future we can give an idea of how much we want to spend on this, or it can suggest how much we could spend, and then it generates a deployment plan. The deployment plan, it is used to basically decide which synthesizers are associated with which of the virtual machine resources we have. So this requires a bit of a meta model. So the bottom box describes how our model looks. Our Cloud Orchestra is composed of CSound and Chuck and SuperCollider and Pure Data synthesizers. These synth programs are basically objects to be instantiated, and we instantiate them as basically synth blocks. The synth block will be allocated to a host, and they will be connected together via, say, jack connections. Then, once all of these things are done, we'll take that synth definition, which consists of host, synth blocks, and connections, and we'll pass it off to a synth depth optimizer, which will be part of our model generator that will use a templater, and it will generate a deployment plan. And it can do so pretty optimally, because we can actually pose our problem in, say, the constraints of linear programming. So given a model of hosts, synths, connections, and an allocation of synthesizers to hosts, we can actually view this as, say, like a integer linear programming problem and actually solve it. So the inputs to our model will be the synthesizers that we want to play, the connections between the synthesizers, our model itself, as well as the resources that are available to us. So the prior slide, this is a simplification of what the inputs actually are. So we basically got the VMs as well as the number of cores that each VM has. We basically try to limit the number of synthesizers to the number of cores. Our output will basically be the allocation of synthesizers to the virtual machines that we have, as well as a deployment plan generated by the model generator. Now, not every deployment plan is created equal. Things that we care about are the efficient use of the resources we have. We don't want to overload the resources, and furthermore, we don't want to have a lot of remote connections. Remote connections are a concern because they impede the latency of the system. If your connections are local to that one virtual machine, the latency is a lot less. So what we want to do is we want to find the best allocation that minimizes this function, which is simply the overflow count plus the number of remote connections. Any allocation that doesn't have any remote connections and any overflow would be completely acceptable. But we really, very few Cloud Orchestras will fit this description, so basically we're looking for a minimum. So, the first thing we want to do is we want to check to see if the allocation overflows cores. So, given a VM, given an allocation to that VM, does that VM have too many synths assigned to it based on the number of cores it has? So, given a virtual machine with two cores, maybe two synths is enough. Whereas assigning three synths to a virtual machine with one core would be pretty unacceptable. Furthermore, different allocations have different quality in terms of remote links. Given the same network, we could reduce the number of remote links by carefully assigning synthesizers to one VM and then having only one remote link to the other VM. We could also have a poor situation where we doubled the number of remote links to achieve exactly the same network. What this will also do is induce a higher latency. So we want to protect against overflow, and we want to protect against remote links. So we essentially want to optimize this equation, which is basically a linear equation, but it's got this allocation matrix, and the allocation matrix, we can't allocate like half of a host. So essentially this is integer linear programming, and it's probably NP-hard. So the neat thing is because it is integer linear programming, or it is linear programming, you can use linear programming to, like a linear programming toolkit, to basically solve and find an optimal solution. So here's an example of one solution in GNU linear programming kit. All right, so we can solve it. We've got a model generator. We've got something that searches for good models and evaluates models. So now what? Well, we actually want to use the Cloud Orchestra. So the general process for using the actual implementation we've got of the Cloud Orchestra is to first define your resources, then to define what your Cloud Orchestra looks like, then to generate a deployment plan, to run it, to connect to it so you can hear it, and then to use the Cloud Orchestra. So first and foremost, you want to specify the hosts that are available to you. So you define your resources, you give them the IP addresses and the username, as well as the number of cores. You can then use a drag-and-drop user interface to define how synthesizers connect to each other. So we provide ADC and DAC synthesizers, and then other synths can be provided, such as, say, this FM generator or a low-pass filter, and these can be implemented using C-Sound or SuperCollider or whatever you like to use. But basically, each one of these boxes will be a separate process. And they have potential to be run on different computers. So once you click the Submit button there, you're basically going to have a deployment plan created, and these synth blocks will basically be run on multiple computers, and they'll be connected together. Once you click Deploy and Generate, it'll generate basically a bunch of shell scripts to basically connect things together, because you're going to have a bunch of remote links, so you're going to have to orchestrate the connection of that. So you're going to have to bring up synths and do that. When you ask it to run, it's going to bring up each of the synthesizers. It's then going to bring up the connections between hosts, and then it's going to connect the synthesizers to those to each other via those remote links, and then that deployment plan will be run. Once that's done, you can connect to, say, the DAC, and then you can listen to that, and that will allow you to connect to your Cloud Orchestra. And then once that occurs, you can use your Cloud Orchestra, whether you provided a UI or you're just going to listen to it. So here's an example of using both the model and the system. So we've got this simple network here laid out, an ADC in the low pass, an FM generator in the low pass, and that goes all to the DAC. We'd get a connection matrix, we'd get a list of cores, and we'd try to generate an allocation matrix of the synths to the virtual machines that we had, given the cores as a limitation. So what does it eventually look like? Well, the end user will see something like this. They'll see this user interface, they'll create a new object, a DAC, they'll create an FM object, and they'll create another low-pass filter object, then they'll connect them together. We'll connect the FM to the LP, we'll connect the LP to LP, something along those lines. So we can create that kind of synthesizer network, and then we can click the Submit Query button, and it will start first to generate it, and then it will synchronize all the synthesizers with the generated deployment plan, and then will deploy. It will then start all the synthesizers and then disconnect them. Then it will connect them appropriately to where they're supposed to be connected to, and then we'll get connected to the Cloud Orchestra so we can listen to it. So it's quite doable. We can use templates, we can generate our Cloud Orchestra. So when you're making a cloud orchestra, what should you watch out for? Well, first of all, if you use star patterns or star formations, where basically everything feeds into one thing, you'll probably get low latency, but you'll also be in danger of high network bandwidth. This doesn't quite scale. Furthermore, if you use a tree, you'll basically get high latency, but you'll use a lot less network bandwidth and you'll scale better. But in all cases, you really want to take advantage of locality. Being local to inside a VM has far lower latency than communicating between virtual machines, because they have to hit the switch. They got to hit the network, and that will incur quite a bit of latency. So it's best to keep everything local. So, in conclusion, what was I talking about? I was talking about taking large orchestras, multi-computer orchestras, and leveraging the utility of cloud computing to enable you to run very large orchestras effectively. But there was the problem of DevOps and system administration, which was quite annoying and would get in the way. It became a gulf of execution. So it was suggested that we use model-driven development. And model-driven development would help us take an idea of what our cloud orchestra looked like and then produce an optimal deployment plan that allowed us to basically make sure that, given the resources available, that we wouldn't have an excessive number of remote links and we wouldn't overload virtual machines with too many synthesizers. This would allow us to generate an optimal deployment plan, which would allow us to play music using multiple computers with ease and take advantage of the resources available to us. Our recommendations were that you should consider a tree network if you want to scale, but generally you want to maximize locality by keeping everything in the same VM. So, model-driven development helps bridge the gulf of execution when trying to use cloud computing to play computer music.